It's Saturday morning, time for Jim Wilson's Florida Outdoor Adventures. And look, quick, folks, look. It may be the only time you see the two of them sitting up and not sound asleep. What sleepyheads. Like I always say, I think they're part cat because, my gosh, they just... But look, they're up looking around, actually. I think they think they're going to, watch this, get a treat? A treat? Did I say treat? Did you think I said treat? Yes, I said treat. Now they want one. Well, in a minute, but you have to do your part first. We're on TV now. You have to see the people out there. They want to see you. Well, let's give congratulations to the FWC and the National Marine Fisheries Service, because guess what? They have finally set, like it is, a red snapper season that will go from June 1st to July 11th. Hopefully they're going to add some more time to it, because I think everyone has tried to convince them that there's a lot more snapper than they're giving us credit for. But that is the last day of fishing will be June 10th up to midnight. So that's what's going on there. The annual Kids Fishing Day, sponsored by the Florida FWC, Half Hitch Tackle, and others, will be taking place. Now, this is confusing, because tomorrow we're going to be talking about the one that the city of Panama City puts on, and that's May 5th at the Life Management Pond. That's where the kids go down and fish in the stocked pond. This one is going to be at the Panama City Marina on Saturday, May 19th, starting at 9 o'clock in the morning. And the kids get a free rod and reel as they go through. They'll have various stations to move along and learn things about the Gulf, learn about fishing, catch and release, casting, all kinds of things. And as they move from station to station to station in groups, then eventually they'll move along and get their free rod and reel, and bait, of course, will be provided, and they'll go down and start fishing. And it's always a wonderful event, because it's a family day, and kids just have such a great time. And of course, I take the little dogs, and the dogs are there, and the kids play with the dogs, and we have a great time. And we do a TV show with them, of course. And I think this has been going on for well over 20 years, because Half Hitch used to sponsor it out on the Panama City Beach Pier. And so it's going to be a great event again this year. And this time, as I say, this time it's down at the Panama City Marina. Now, to any of you who may be from out of state, or even here in state, and don't have any kind of a fishing license, if you're from out of state, you have to have a saltwater fishing license or a freshwater license to fish anywhere. But if you go to the city marina, you pay $1 and you're covered, because they have a blanket license that covers anyone fishing at the pier once you pay your dollar fee. And they've been catching a lot of nice Spanish mackerel. I talked to a guy that even caught some king mackerel from the pier. And of course, we're getting ready for flounder season to start picking up. That'll be mostly by boat, but they catch some there from the pier around on different areas. And a lot of good fishing. Now, I talked to my friend Eddie Eagle down in Port St. Joe a couple of days ago, and he said that down at Howard Creek right now, it is just unbelievable how good the freshwater fishing is, how big the brim are, how many they're catching, and just really, really doing well. I'm sure he doesn't fish for bass, but I'm sure if he were trying, he would be catching bass too, because this is a time of the year that just about everything is on the bite. So that's what's going on down there. And what did I forget about? Let's take a look at tides and see what our tides are doing today. Not a bad tide, and there's still a lot of redfish in the pass, and there's Spanish, still Pompano on the move. And as you're getting offshore now, lots and lots of big beeliners, and you can catch those out on any of the bridge spans. And they're still catching a few cobia out offshore. It was a poor year for cobia on the inside, but offshore they're still catching them, and live bait, of course, will do it. Red grouper is open, and black grouper, gag grouper, really, what we call them, black grouper here, is still closed. But a lot of good fishing out there. And then take a look at Port St. Joe. Talking to my friend Alan Duke down at Presnell's Marina, they're catching tons of flounder down there now. Both the flounder are doing well, and so are redfish and speckled trout. And then as you move up into the canal, you're going to start getting into black bass, and especially when you get over to Lake Wimico. An interesting thing on fishing Lake Wimico is the freshwater shrimp. And if you take a fine mesh crab net or net and you dip down in the grass and dump a big net full of grass into a 5-gallon bucket and shake it, when you look back in the bucket, you'll see all these little tiny shrimp in there. Well, that's why Lake Wimico is such a great fishing spot, because it's like fish candy. The fish just are gobbling these things up. So you use little tiny hooks, something like a 12, and put two or three of them on there. And trust me, folks, it's an incredible bait, and you will do very, very well. Put a little cool water in with them to keep them fresh. And another thing, if you're fishing with worms now, freshwater fishing, it gets so hot that any kind of a worm bucket that you have, the things are going to die from the heat and turn to mush. So take a regular bottle of water, freeze it, pour enough out so that when you freeze it, it doesn't burst the bottle, and put that in with your worms. It'll keep them nice and cool, and they'll stay alive, and they'll be happy worms when you hook them on and drop them down in there to do some fishing. Speaking of fishing, we had the opportunity, got to do Apalachicola tides. We forgot about those. Apalachicola, of course, fishing is great down there, and both fresh and salt water again. And that's the nice thing about that. You don't know which one you're going to get, because there's a mix one way or the other. But anyhow, that's what's happening down there. And don't forget about our friends that we love so much up at Tanya's Garden. I do all the cooking and grocery shopping. I have something from Tanya's right now. The white acre peas, the black eyed peas, the English peas, those are great. The green beans are wonderful. The corn is great. It's all like going right to the farm, because it's farm fresh. They've been having strawberries kind of on and off, but and they'll be having blueberries coming in pretty quick. And of course, bananas, 39 cents a pound, the most beautiful tomatoes you could expect. Right across the street from Stoll Tractor on Highway 77, just before you get to Haney Vocational, Tanya's Garden. Heidi, yes, see, I got you to wake up, because you've got to tell them to go down. If they've got a dog, take it to Chad, the dog groomer, because Chad is so good with the dogs. Heidi's had her summer haircut. Gracie's had her bath. He takes care of the teeth, because dogs get tartar buildup on their teeth. Chad's is right next to Dan's Pawn Shop, and you can't miss him. A super guy. Drop in and tell him we sent you, and I'll appreciate it. And of course, again, AC Service is the folks that, if you have any kind of air conditioning problems, you call them, because this time of the year, it's so important with the air gone, because if you let your house go without any air conditioning with all this heat, you'll have mold and mildew building up in no time at all. 522-4055. 522-4055. AC Service. Wendy will have Ed there on the spot, and you'll get excellent service at a very modest charge from a nice family. We will be back, and when we come back, we're having the most incredible fishing experience I've had in a long time.
For everything you need on or off the water, visit the Panama City and St. Andrews Marinas. Both locations provide you with easy access boat slips, ramps, fuel, bait, and tackle. Come visit our ship stores and see our unique nautical gifts and clothing, or just relax with a cool drink and grab a snack while watching the boats come in. Don't forget that mariner on your shopping list. Come by and see our unique nautical gifts, cards, and clothing at Panama City or St. Andrews Marina. Call 872-7272 for more information.
Hey everybody, this is Brad Stewart. Stevens coming to you from Sunjammers Water Sports on Highway 79. You know us for your fishing, kayaks, and all your sailing needs. What you may not know is that we stock a full line of inshore and offshore tackle, specializing in the Captain Joe fish-on lures. We stock his grouper baits, his SS minnows, his shredders, along with all of your gulp baits, Joe jigs, the edge hook, your U-Pro rods, and live bait. Come see us at Sunjammers Water Sports, 315 North Highway 79.
Hi, this is Larry Lee from Coin and Bullion Reserves. Do you need to raise some quick cash? People from all over the southeastern United States have been doing that for over 39 years here at Coin and Bullion Reserves, and here's how it's done. You go to your jewelry box, you get that old unused gold chain, you bring it to Coin and Bullion Reserves at the corner of East Avenue and 15th Street in Panama City, where you will get more for your gold than any place in the United States, and you can take that to the bank.
Lindsay's Sweet Deals Furniture is more living room, bedroom, and dining sets than any store in the Panhandle and at the lowest prices. We offer over 20 styles of bedding sets at prices you will not believe, including the best 6-pound Visco memory foam bed on the market. We have over 30 sleeper sofas on the floor and ready to go. Come visit us at our only location, which is just over the bridge on the beach. No furniture or bedding store will beat our prices. We will save you a lot of money. Bring your truck and haul it away, or we will deliver it for you. And remember, if you don't see me in the store, you're in the wrong store.
When was the last time you took a few minutes out of your busy schedule to enjoy the simple things? The wide open spaces? The uncharted territory? The moments that seem to stick with you for a lifetime? Well, what are you waiting for? Half hitch. Get out there.
All right. I was telling you about the fishing experience. We were up in Holmes County at Bonifay High School with some folks there that Pat, one of them is Pat's student, a young man with some visual impairment, and others, and had a great day to go out to the farm that the school has where they have this beautiful lake, and it's full of bass, and kids got to do some fishing. I got to do some watching, and we had a great time. So I hope you'll enjoy the video. Take a look. High school with a bunch of young folks, part of Pat's class, and we're fishing in a private pond, and I'm waiting to get everybody get organized, but got one young man already made a cast. You got anything? Oh, look out. Hey, that's pretty neat. Swing that one around here and let me take a look. Hey, that's the way to start. That's the way to start the day. Yeah, they're all fishing there. Yeah, one coming in down there. I think we got one. Nope. They're swinging up. Another nice little bass.
That's about a keeper right there, ain't it?
12 inches. I think we're throwing them all back today, though.
Hey, are we throwing them back?
Yeah, we're throwing them back. There you go.
Yeah. Are you going to show this on the TV thing?
Yeah, next Saturday.
Next Saturday?
Not this week, but next week.
Okay, because I already looked on there. And
our fishing team out here at the fishing day that they have every year out here. And when I go around, why don't you go ahead and introduce yourselves. Just shout your name out loud.
My name's Brandy.
Well, let's start over here. Well, wait a minute. Go ahead now.
Crystal.
JC.
Jamie.
Brady.
All right. Don't be bashful. Coach?
No. Ron Dixon, assistant principal.
All right.
Hold your fish up. Did you just catch that one?
He caught it. Sir.
Oh, you caught it. Okay. Hang on. Hey, Travis, how are you? Please. I have our cooks on. You all introduce yourselves, too.
Say you cook some hot dogs and stuff like that.
Huh?
I'm Lee Rohn.
Okay, and you're a secretary?
I'm secretary at Holmes County High.
All right, and coach?
Yeah, Coach Dixon and assistant principal.
Oh, all right. It looks like we've got your work cut out for you today.
Absolutely.
Here come the chow hounds. Made to order. Miss Pat sure is sorry she's not here.
I know, we miss Miss Pat. Are they? I got that. Some chips.
Yes, Dalton got one. How many did you catch today?
Four.
Oh, you caught four. Is that the biggest?
Yes, sir.
Hey, Travis just brought one in. Good work.
I brought two of them in, actually.
Yeah, I know. What'd you say your name is again?
My name's Dylan Skinner.
Dylan Skinner. And who do you charter with out of Panama City?
I charter with Real Addiction Charters.
Okay.
And Circle W Charters out of Panama City.
And who are that? Who's that captain?
That's Mickey Locke, Captain Mickey Locke, and Captain Chris Wee-Wee.
Okay. And you got any phone numbers?
Not off the top of my head, but I've got right. Some business cards I'll look up just a little while.
All right.
Listen, I'm here with Emily Rohn. She's the teacher here at the school. And we're in, what school? You're at
Holmes County High School.
Holmes County High School. Okay, I just want to get the name right.
Yes.
Okay, in Bonifay.
Located in Bonifay, yes,
okay,
sir.
And you teach special ed there?
Yes, sir.
And do we have all your class here?
Yes, it's a full attendance.
Oh, good. How many years have you been doing this?
This is my first year.
Oh, really? Well, they had it last year. Who did it last year? Another teacher?
I wouldn't know. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if this class came out here last year.
Yeah, Pat came with them. My wife came with them last year.
Now, we came out here a few months ago.
Oh, and that's when it was. Oh, okay.
Yep. We came out back in October.
And the county maintains this lake.
Our high school ag class does.
That is wonderful. So it's taught as kind of a you have an ag program?
Yes, we have a very, very good ag teacher, Chad Ganey, and he brings his kids out here multiple times a week, and they work on it.
That is wonderful, you know, to have it's good to hear we have some vocational training going on in some of the schools. You know, in my day, we had all kind of vocational training. I'm old. Well, it's been such a pleasure to meet you and your mother and all the other administrators and folks. You're just doing a wonderful job.
Really enjoyed you coming out here. The kids have been so excited. So.
Well, I am too. I'm always excited to be around kids who want to fish. I was the first person to run a national TV spot called Hooked on Fishing, Not on Drugs.
Oh, yeah.
In 1985. And I've always been a great admirer and supporter of that. And then, if you want to get high, try it the way my son does. He climbed Mount Everest.
Wow.
That's getting high the hard way.
Yes, the extremely hard way. So.
But again, thank you for lunch, and please thank all the rest of the folks.
I certainly will. Thank you so much.
All right. And I'm going to be going along. I've got to go shoot a TV spot.
All right, listen, you fish sitting up here. What's happening? You guys all taking a break?
No, yes, but I'm just taking a break because I don't really know how to fish. But
well, you don't learn sitting in a chair.
I know.
Unless it's on the side of the lake.
I know.
How about there? Who's caught a fish? Raise your hand. All right, Jamie, you caught one. You didn't catch one? How about you? Have you caught one? Have you caught one? Well, you know other folks are catching them, so I guarantee you.
They have luck on their side.
Huh?
That's because they have luck on their side.
No, it's perseverance. Look, here comes one coming up here right now.
I can catch ladies.
I can catch.
All right. Well, listen, it's been so much fun being with you all, and we'll see you the next time you do it. Okay?
Bye.
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 Bye. Hey, buddy, are you? That looks like the same fish.
No, I got other fish in there. I just caught one when you were way over there.
Okay, so how many you got in the bucket now?
Four.
Four?
Just about
how
one.
Many of yours?
Ah.
Catch?
Five. Five's the limit. All right, well, listen, I'm leaving, Travis, so thanks. Good to see you.
You too.
Hi, this is Larry Lee from Coin and Bullion Reserves. Do you need to raise some quick cash? People from all over the southeastern United States have been doing that for over 39 years here at Coin and Bullion Reserves, and here's how it's done. You go to your jewelry box, you get that old unused gold chain, you bring it to Coin and Bullion Reserves at the corner of East Avenue and 15th Street in Panama City, where you will get more for your gold than any place in the United States, and you can take that to the bank.
Lindsay, Sweet Deals Furniture is more living room, bedroom, and dining sets than any store in the Panhandle and at the lowest prices. We offer over 20 styles of bedding sets at prices you will not believe, including the best 6-pound Visco memory foam bed on the market. We have over 30 sleeper sofas on the floor and ready to go. Come visit us at our only location, which is just over the bridge on the beach. No furniture or bedding store will beat our prices. We will save you a lot of money. Bring your truck and haul it away, or we will deliver it for you. And remember, if you don't see me in the store, you're in the wrong store.
Hey everybody, this is Brad Stevens coming to you from Sunjammers Water Sports on Highway 79. You know us for your fishing, kayaks, and all your sailing needs. What you may not know is that we stock a full line of inshore and offshore tackle, specializing in the Captain Joe fish-on lures. We stock his grouper baits, his SS minnows, his shredders, along with all of your gulp baits, Joe jigs, the edge hook, your U-Pro rods, and live bait. Come see us at Sunjammers Water Sports, 315 North Highway 79.
The Captain Anderson makes fishing a breeze. There's a galley on board, and your comfortable trip is all-inclusive. Rod, reel, tackle, bait, and your fishing license. The traditional all-day trip from 7 to 5 p.m. Come aboard the Captain Anderson for a relaxing day of bottom fishing. There's plenty of room, so bring the whole family. It's a whopping big adventure, and that's no fishtail. The Captain Anderson is located at Captain Anderson's Marina, where the fish are always biting and the kids are always smiling. Please call for cruise schedules.
When was the last time you took a few minutes out of your busy schedule to enjoy the simple things? The wide open spaces? The uncharted territory? The moments that seem to stick with you for a lifetime? Well, what are you waiting for? Half hitch. Get out there.
All right. Well, it was such an honor to get invited up and go with them, and it's such a beautiful place because imagine a school system that owns a full, huge working farm so that they can have a true vocational program, because there's a lot of kids up country that do want to be farmers, and it's a wonderful occupation. It's a lifetime occupation. And they learn all about it firsthand on the farm, and then they have this beautiful lake, and that's part of the attraction up there. So the whole thing was, just salute the folks in Holmes County so much. That's such a great idea and a great opportunity. I look forward to going back on another trip. And next time I'm gonna take the doggies. I wasn't sure about it this time. Now, my friend Eddie Eagle down there, he and his wife Marilyn on Treasures by the Sea, as you're going into Port St. Joe on Highway 98, just before you get into town across the bridge, on the left, it's kind of an interesting store. But they have all these beautiful shells, and here's a couple of examples. This is a horn conch that Marilyn has there by the box full. And what she does, these things come in, and they're brought in by shrimpers mostly, and they're all black, they've got barnacles, all kind of stuff on them, and you can see here what she does. She uses a combination of muriatic acid and bleach, and they turn out this beautiful white color. This is a small one, you can see it fits in the palm of my hand, but she has some that are as big as my hat. And they're all for sale. These are only $3. And then this one is a very rare Gulf shell called a Juno. It's a J-U-N-O, and I wasn't sure. She told me, and I looked it up on the internet. Sure enough, it's a Juno shell, and these come in, and of course she has to clean them and polish them. These are $3 each also, and it just so happens that tomorrow is my grandson's birthday out in California. I sent him a card, but I picked these up. He loves shells, so I'm going to send him those two shells. Now, the other thing that they have all these big helmet shells and all kind of others. They're closing their store. So things are on bargain prices right now. And they do have some very interesting and unusual antiques. They have a, you know, Pat and I went to Venice and visited one of the glass factories. They have the most gorgeous handmade Venetian glass mirror that you've ever seen. It is not an antique because they still make them, but it's been valued at somewhere near $1,000. And I guarantee you, when somebody sees that, they're going to visualize that on their room, and Eddie will give you a super price on it because they've got to move all that stuff out of there because they're going to be moving. Now, another reminder that on May 5th, that's next Saturday, the Kids Fishing Day, sponsored by the Panama City Leisure Services, will be taking place at the Life Management Pond. This is the 13th year, and it just so happens it's the first year that I won't be able to be there. I'm going to try to get my friend Mel Bankhead to cover it for me and take the dogs. But they provide rods and reels for the kids. They provide bait. They provide food for the parents and for the kids. The Civitan Club does. And they have prizes, and they have door prizes, and they have all kinds of events. And it's just a super wonderful day. Kids have to have parents with them, no babysitting. But it's next Saturday at the Life Management Pond, so be sure you show up there. Bring your kids and have a good time. It starts at 7 a.m. and goes to about 11, and it's always a wonderful, it's well stocked. That's the nice thing. Mostly catfish are our target, but invariably somebody catches a big carp, or they catch a big or nice brim or something else, because there's a variety in there. But the main target is catfish. So we'll miss being there, but we're going to be over in Mobile for Emily, our granddaughter, is having her college graduation. Emily Newton. Well, that's going to wrap it up for today's edition. Tight lines, folks.
The weather is beautiful this time of year, and that means out.